For more on the Task Force PhilHealth's report, we now have with us Commissioner Greco Belgica. He's the head of the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission. Good morning, sir, and thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Good morning, Christian, and good morning to our viewers and listeners.
Okay, just to be clear, is Health Secretary Francisco Duque III, who chairs PhilHealth, is he already off the hook?
No, definitely not 100%. The investigation is continuing. We've had, in the course of investigation, we were able to secure documents and evidences that opened up more and other leads to investigation that we have to substantiate and document. So Secretary Duque is not yet off the hook. A thorough investigation of and determination of liabilities is being done in the entire PhilHealth. Not only that, sir, we're also helping address the systemic problems done in PhilHealth. So, yeah, that's all being done today.
Okay, so far, based on the task force's recommendations, he was merely admonished, right? Or he should be admonished. Mm-hmm. Why was it? Why was it the case?
We were only given 30 days, and 30 days is not enough to investigate everything. So we only were able to pick an issue that we know we can finish in 30 days, and that was part of that was the IRM. We had ideas and opened up ideas dun sa kanilang IT systems. Now we found informations that, even their accounting system has a very big problem. That's why it's very unclear and very vague. Therefore, it's open and exposed to corruption. And not only their fraud violation mechanisms pertaining to their IT as a problem, but their entire IT system is fragmented and unintegrated. Mm-hmm. So that's why it creates chaos and confusion. So all these leads are being pursued. And that's why the admonishment to Secretary Duque probably is to signify that the investigation, signify to the people that the investigation is not yet finished, because we kind of knew this will be the reaction of people if they don't see Secretary Duque. But you see, sir, it's the admissions that we heard in the Senate and Congress now has to be substantiated with the documents and evidence. So that's why we have boxes and boxes of memos, resolutions, minutes of the meetings that we're looking into. Sa kami lang po, sa PECC lang, ganun po kami. Tapos yung mga composite teams ng task force are also doing the same thing, so that we can all substantiate and prepare a good case, a strong case, that the courts will not dismiss. Kasi po, we can't give in to public pressure and then file cases na wala naman pong laman. Dahil in the end, this will come back to us if we file unsubstantiated cases.
Okay, that's true. But of course, the next question is, people might think that the decision by the task force to clear Secretary Duque of any liability when it comes to the PhilHealth mess might have been the result of President Rodrigo Duterte himself previously clearing Francisco Duque III, the secretary, of any liability. Was this affected by the president's pronouncements in favor of Secretary Duque?
Sir, I'll clear up something. No, the task force, neither the president cleared no one, not even Secretary Duque. We have not cleared anyone of a liability. That's why we are investigating. The president has reiterated his trust to Secretary Duque, but has not stopped us or ordered us to stop investigation. In fact, he continues to tell us to investigate. So wala akong kini-clear dito. Yung 30 days and yung aming po submission is only saying na ito po ang natapos namin for the 30 days in the issue that we investigated. However, creating the composite teams means na we are pursuing the investigation, and this will still include everyone. In fairness, sir, even kahit wala po si Secretary Duque, hindi naman po mawababang opisyal ang amin pong kinasuhan. It was the inirekomendang kasuhan dahil yung presidente mismo ng PhilHealth is part of it. Number two po, yung walong, the eight names that was recommended for case filing, it's only the findings namin sa task force. But, you know, PACC alone, hindi po kasama yung ibang mga members ng task force. Us, PACC alone has already submitted 16 names that we feel should be filed cases upon and evidence warrants for cases we filed against them, and we've already submitted this to the DOJ.
Okay,
to the DOJ task force.
So okay, so just to be clear, the task force, or including of course the PACC, you're not saving Secretary Duque because the president had issued pronouncements before in favor of the secretary. It's not the case here.
And that he trusts, yes, sir, definitely. That the statements of the president is that he trusts Secretary Duque for now, because you know the president is a lawyer and a fiscal. He knows how to look at evidence, and he knows that the evidence has to be seen out. We saw admissions, we saw links, and we saw ideas in the Senate and in Congress. Now it's a process to substantiate those documents, including the things that some people are saying, officials and whistleblowers are saying. We are looking into it.
Mm-hmm. Now, of course, it's logical to suspect that, or sometimes it's very difficult not to suspect that the chairman of the PhilHealth has nothing to do with the supposed anomalies there, given the sensitive nature of that position. But during your investigation over the past 30 days, did you actually find any link, for example, between Secretary Duque and the controversial interim reimbursement mechanism?
The thing is, he didn't sign the IRM, sir. So if you want to pin down, really put down a really big case, now you have to look at the minutes. Now you have to look at the participations and probably be able to get together something there. No? So yun nga po ang point, eh. It's one thing to hear admissions and stories, and it's another thing to file cases and substantiate your stories. So andun po tayo sa process na in that process. And, you know, we have boxes of documents in the office that our lawyers are all looking at or looking into to see yung mga participations and probable liabilities ng mga officials po dyan. So, of course, being head of the board, of course, everyone's a suspect already, because what you did and what you did not do can be held against you.
Precisely.
So that's what we're doing right now, sir.
Yeah, but the very nature of his position, the fact that even if there was no signature of Secretary Duque in any of the documents, as you mentioned, pertaining to the IRM, the fact that he didn't do anything about it, was that sufficient enough to merit a possible case against him?
Yeah, that's what we have. That's why we have to look at the minutes to see the minutes of the meeting. What I'm saying is, so that we know exactly the acts that was committed and the liability that may go into it. Number two, sir, the IRM is a special reimbursement mechanism. This is not the normal operation procedures of the corporation. Yun po ang mas malaking problema. As stated before, COA has there's an advisory from COA that Tag PhilHealth has been losing 154 billion pesos from 2013 to 2018. Ang IRM po is 14 billion. So yun, if you look at it, and that's what we are doing, and that's really the meat of the case. There are plenty more liabilities there because of those fraudulent claims. So yung IRM, again, it's just one IRM, yung COVID IRM, ang very problematic portion. So if you look at, now without, we're looking into it, hindi ho, I don't know kung, right now, I don't know kung paano sila liligtas doon. But then again, I have to say that we have to see the documents that will be submitted in court.
Okay.
And the resolutions, the memos, the minutes of the meeting that will be submitted in court, so that it will hold ground, sir.
Okay. Because to be fair also to Secretary Duque, if there's no evidence pointing to his alleged liabilities, then there should be no case filed against him, right? But let's go to the whistleblower, Thorson Montes Keith. I remember he tagged Secretary Duque as the head of the so-called mafia at PhilHealth during the Senate investigation. And shortly before we went on this interview, he was quoted as saying or making another set of accusations against the secretary pertaining to the supposed liability at PhilHealth. Now, based on your investigation, did the whistleblower actually provide any evidence against the secretary during the course of your investigation?
Well, he has reports that he gave as much as he can. So we all are considering it, including the Senate and congressional reports and the reports of Senator Gordon. We are all looking into it. And him being an insider of PhilHealth, his suggestions, opinions, and findings are important because this gives leads. So, but then he doesn't have all the documents that's needed to, kasi hindi naman niya kayang kunin yun. Eh. So, that's our part to subpoena the documents according to the leads that he is given. So, ganun po ang nangyayari, with him, with Thorson Keith now.
So, can you give us an example of the leads that he provided, specifically because he was tagging Secretary Duque?
Well, marami po siyang ibinigay na leads. Example, yung sasabi niya, yung grabe ang corruption, yan, sa kanya po nangyari yan, yung 15 billion pesos, sa kanya po nangyari yan. And now, he is tagging Red Cross. Yun, yung mga leads niya, dahil Red Cross is indeed a beneficiary of PhilHealth. So, this has to be looked into dahil there are possibilities. So, we need to look at the contract. There's a MOA kasi normally that's built and then as to what transpired in the MOA and see by law there can be liability. So yun po, yun mga pinoprovide niya po.
Okay, and of course the other question is, correct me if I'm wrong, was there any regional vice president included in your report or included in the recommendation for the filing of charges?
Yes. Yes, the investigation went as far as the regional vice president and even down to the regional computer chief or the IT chief. So that's why in the beginning of the investigation, I've always said that PhilHealth problem in PhilHealth is from head to toe. And that's where we went through the investigations. And we were able to validate information that we already had and the theories that we already had. That the PhilHealth IT validation mechanism is really very poor. That allowed monies to be stolen from the organization for many decades. Mm-hmm. So yan po. And then cases was also filed. Kasi amin po sa PACC recommendations of these people to be filed for cases to be filed against them, including to the regional offices. Were also placed in our recommendation.
But were you able to identify really who belonged to the so-called mafia at PhilHealth? Because during the course of the Senate hearings, we were seeing contradicting allegations or allegations and counter-allegations from seeming factions within PhilHealth. So it might seem that one force or one group of mafia or one mafia was just trying to save its own neck and trying to hurl accusations against the other.
Mafia wars, you know? So I think that mafia, the mafia is an overused term, or is an abused term, I guess. If you talk about mafia-like syndicated operation, malinaw po yun, there is. Pero if you talk about mafia, well, I have to see, mahirap po yun kasi you're talking about drugs, you're talking about weapons, so I don't think they're in that category for now. I've not seen people killing each other for positions. I've seen them trying to file charges against them. Pero as to the involvement of those people and or of persons tagged to be mafia, yes, they are all being investigated, both from both camps. That's why even the president read the names of those who are involved in the both from the board and the executive committee, and investigations po are ruling naman sa regional level. And in fact, nirelieve na po ang buong region. So I don't think any mafia will if even if there is a real mafia in Philev, I don't think any mafia will survive this presidency and this administration. They will all be broken down and charges will be filed against them.
In the case of the resigned Vice President Rodolfo Del Rosario, is he also off the hook, or are you still investigating him? Because the basic question was, this is also raised by several senators, how come he was not included in the list of recommendations for the filing of charges?
Again, sir, it's because of the case that was investigated by the PhilHealth. No? By the task force, basically yung IRM ang tinapos namin or sinimulan namin. So many of the cases that the Del Rosario was involved was not only with the IRM. So he is not off the hook. Investigations and cases, actually marami yung cases ang inilagay sa kanya na we have to look into. So he's not off the hook, definitely. Okay.
Now, speaking of the interim reimbursement mechanism, how many healthcare institutions are we talking about here, or you have identified as those who received bogus claims from PhilHealth?
I think 700 hospitals and healthcare institutions of the 5,000 that were identified. So yun po ang information namin right now.
And you have strong evidence against these hospitals as well?
Yun po ang isa-isahin namin. Kasi yung ang issue naman po dyan is what they received and how they spent it in their claims. A lot of hospitals, not all, are claiming COVID illness or non-COVID illness to claim more from PhilHealth. So if they have participated in that kind of fraudulent activities, then cases will be filed against them. So an audit of the claims is being done and has to be done. And that's why we are in helping the new administration of PhilHealth to put in a capable and able IT system that will allow a quick audit of the claims that has been made so that fraudulent claims can be identified and monies that were stolen can be collected back from the hospitals.
Okay, and lastly, is there a way to basically recover some of those huge amounts that were received by many of these hospitals?
Yes, sir, definitely. And that is one thing that we are concentrating on right now. And we have proposed, kasi po, you know, the hospitals and the HCIs, the healthcare institutions, monthly claims from PhilHealth. So when they're upon audit and fraudulent claims are found or overpayments were found to have been made, this can be charged to their future claims. So in that way, we can recover the monies or the billions of funds that was stolen from government or that was fraudulently claimed, while and in the same time, not disrupting the services that the hospitals need.
Okay, Commissioner Greco Bellica, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.